Programming assignments allow students to submit code files in any programming language to Gradescope. Instructors can then autograde or manually grade the code and also check for code similarity. Programming assignments are available as part of our Gradescope Complete product. To start from the course dashboard, let's select Assignments on the left and click to create a new assignment. We'll select the programming assignment type and click Next, and then type the assignment name. For programming assignments, there are two options for grading the student's code submissions: autograding and manual grading. If we want to use a code autograder, we set it up ahead of time and it will run a series of instructor-defined test cases on student code submissions and give students feedback in real time. If we want to manually grade the code submissions, we'll use a rubric and inline feedback similar to other types of Gradescope assignments. We can choose to only autograde submissions, only manually grade them, or to use a combination of manual and autograding. For this assignment, let's use both autograding and manual grading. We'll put in the total score for the assignment here and select the Enable Manual Grading box. As with other assignment types, we'll set a time window when students can submit. We can optionally enable group submissions, and if we want students to see each other's autograder results in a competition style assignment, we can enable the leaderboard feature as well. Okay, we're now on the Edit Outline page. Here we can add any questions we want to manually grade. For example, we might decide that in addition to the 90 points awarded by the autograder, we want to also manually grade students for style out of 10 points. If we were only using an autograder and no manual grading, we could just click Save without adding additional questions. And if we were only manually grading, we could assign 0 points to the autograder question. Once we click Save, we're now on the Configure Autograder page. From here, we can click this Guidelines link to see all the specifications and guidelines for setting up the code autograder and our test cases. Code autograders on Gradescope work with any programming language that can be run on a Linux-based system. We have some examples of existing autograders in the left sidebar here, and there are more user-provided examples on our Community Resources page. For any questions in regards to setting up code autograder for Gradescope, please don't hesitate to reach out to help@gradescope.com. Once our autograder is ready, we can upload it to the Configure Autograder page and test it out. So to do that, let's jump to our demo programming assignment in our Gradescope 202 course, which already has an autograder set up for a Python assignment where students were asked to write a calculator program. After the release date passes, students can submit any number of files of any type to the programming assignment, either by dragging and dropping them from their computer or via their GitHub or Bitbucket account. If an autograder has been set up, students will see the results as soon as they submit. Past test cases will appear in green and failed ones will appear in red. So here we can see that the student passed most of the autograder tests but failed two of them. Students can use this feedback to resubmit as many times as they like before the due date to try to improve their autograder score. If we've created any questions for manual grading, we can grade these from the Grade Submissions tab. We'll build a rubric for each question, just as we would for any other type of Gradescope assignment, and we can also click on any line of code and type inline comments. Then finally, regardless of whether we've set up an autograder, we can go to the Review Similarity tab on the left to check for similar submissions. Code similarity is currently only supported for these programming languages, but it's on our roadmap to add more. In this case, we can see that Darlene's submission is 89% similar to Dale's, and we can click on the name of the file to view their similarity report. So we'll see Darlene's code here on the left and Dale's code on the right, and then we'll see any similar lines highlighted. Gradescope Code Similarity uses Measure of Software Similarity, or MOS, behind the scenes, and it will be able to detect if submissions are similar even if students included extra commenting or renamed functions or variables. If we want to, we can print these similarity reports, and back on the Review Similarity page, we can also upload a template file of any starter code that we've provided to the students. That way, the starter code is excluded from the similarity results.